In this Photoshop tutorial, we're going to combine two images. We're going to blend them together, but then I'm going to show you how to use channels to really make the face stand out and separate it from the background. Let's combine the images. With the Move tool selected, click and hold in the middle of the image, then look at the tabs at the top, drag up into the tab that you want to go into. Don't let go yet. Move your pointer into the middle, then hold the Shift key and release. The Shift key will drop it in the center. I'm going to hit Alt Option and I'm just going to drag on the scroll wheel to zoom out so we can see the full area, and we just want to resize and reposition our model. Control T or Command T for free transform. Click in the middle and we'll drag off to the side. And let's drag this out a little bit. See if it's squishy like that. Hold down the Shift key to constrain it. And that's going to be a nice little combining there. Hit the Enter key to apply. We've now combined the two images into two layers. Now we want to blend them. Let's do our classic blend, but before we do, I want to show you something really interesting, how you can select a face. So if we go into the channels, you'll see there's three channels here, red, green, and blue. We're going to hold down the Control key and click on the red channel. And what that's going to do is it's going to select our skin tones. But we want to inverse the selection, so let's choose Select, Inverse. All right, so we've inverted that selection, and that's going to select all this part of her face. Let's go to the layers. With our layer selected, hit Control J, and that's going to copy it a little bit. Let me just hide the layer so you can see. This is what we selected just using that red channel. Okay, I'm going to hide that for now. Turn on both of our layers. Now let's do a classic blend between the foreground and the background. So we want to create a layer mask. That's the first step. Then we want to create a black to white gradient. Hit the D key. We'll reset foreground background to black and white. Choose the gradient. And then up the top, we're going to be using the foreground to background gradient. Make sure we're linear. 100% opacity. Excellent. Now what we want to do on the mask is click and drag across. And as we do this, notice how we get this beautiful, smooth, seamless blend. That's awesome. And for some people, that might be enough. But I want to go a little bit further. We want to show this face. So remember when we made this selection, if we turn it on, notice now that just gives it a little bit more body. Now, if you wanted to make that face pop more, just hit Control J one more time and you could add another copy on there. And that would just kind of thicken it up a little bit. But let's keep it like that, a nice dreamy mood. Now you could continue and do something like this, you know, make something that looks like a movie poster if you want, just by using the same techniques. So why don't you drop a comment and let me know if this tutorial was useful or you learned anything new. And if you haven't yet hit that subscribe button, go ahead and turn that on and turn on notifications, and then you won't miss any of my future tutorials. So anyway, guys, if you like this, smash the like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.